Yo, what's up everyone? Kevin here. In this video, I just want to share with you guys all the gear that I've brought to New Zealand and just highlight for you guys some of my favorite gear that I've brought. There's a lot here, so let's get into it. Starting with these pants. I picked these up right before my trip started. These are the Volcom Arthur Longo Gore-Tex pants. And I can honestly say these are like my favorite snowboard pants. What makes them so good is the fit. They are like super baggy, super lightweight, and are just insanely comfortable to wear like as I'm riding. One mistake I made last winter is I was riding the Volcom L pants, and the Volcom L's were just had some like tightness in places, and so you weren't really able to move too freely. With these Longo pants, they're like super baggy, they're Gore-Tex, and I actually got these on sale because they're last year's model for super baggy snowboard pants. Got them on sale at a sweet price. Yeah, loving these pants. My new favorite pants, the Arthur Longo Gore-Tex pants. So the next thing I want to highlight are my snowboard boots. At the moment, they're kind of in pieces because I'm drying them out from a day on the mountain, but these are Vans High Standard Pro boots. I've been wearing these now for a year. For me, these are just like the perfect snowboard boot. You got the traditional laces, you got the power strap up top. The flex on these is like medium, so like a good kind of like do everything flex. They're good in the park, good for free riding. For me, Vans boots too are just the most comfortable snowboard boots. Not too like aggressive, so you don't get any like weird pain points on your feet. Perform really well. And with the traditional laces, I've been riding these now for like 6 months and the first pair of laces are still fine. But if something happens with these traditional laces, it's so easy to like swap out. So for me, I like traditional laces. I like the Vans boots for comfort, and these have been performing like insanely well. I've been riding these Volcom Brighton mitts out here, and these have been great too. They're like a mid-weight mitt, so they're not too heavy and warm, but they're also not too light. And they've got like a really good grip on the palm. So the grip is awesome for riding through the terrain park, for getting grabs. That grip is super good. Straps, so you can dangle these off of the chairlift. And they also have like a soft thumb. So if you need to wipe off your goggles or camera lens, then you can do that with these. So for me, I like simple mitts. I think I got these on sale as well. So the Volcom Brighton mitts, got them for a good deal and wore them all summer long too. And they're still in like pretty much perfect condition. The next thing I want to mention, this is kind of like a throwback, but I've been riding this Jones Descent backpack now. I like 3 or 4 seasons. Highlights of this backpack, it's got the helmet carry, which not a lot of backpacks have a helmet carry, but the fact that you can just like throw your helmet onto the back like that just makes it super like convenient. I'm using this helmet carry like almost every day. So if I ever get a new backpack, I'll definitely get one with the helmet carry. So many functional pockets, like up top, I put all my like camera batteries in there, maybe like a pair of sunglasses. I think it's the 25 liter. So the 25 liter is like big enough to get everything you need in there. And then it also has like a pretty comfortable back. So if I do have a bunch of stuff in here, this is really comfortable. The hip straps have pockets as well. So you got, I think I've got some sunscreen in there at the moment. Spring riding at Carjordan, New Zealand, you definitely want to bring some sunscreen. So yeah, really functional backpack. Just makes the day of snowboarding that much better. So I've been riding 2 different boards. Capita helped me out with a couple boards this early season. First, the Arthur Longo Pro model, the Aeronaut. This thing has been awesome for carving, for riding through pow, just everything, like side hits and everything. It's a bit of a stiffer snowboard, and I actually really like the stiffness because you can be charging at high speeds, and the stiffer profile and this positive camber just give you a lot of support and stabilization at high speeds. Snap and ollie through the tail, probably see that positive camber right there. Had some pow days surprisingly here in Carjona on it, and it's just been super fun. And I really like the artwork on this board and the whole style. So I think this is gonna be a board I'm gonna ride a lot for free riding and just for like hitting side hits around the mountain. I've also been riding this board in the park. Surprisingly on this trip, We haven't had a ton of park days. The weather's been a bit on and off, pow days. There's been a bunch of down days because of wind. So I haven't had a ton of park days yet, but this is the Capita Indoor Survival. This one surprised me. It's pretty soft, really good for butters and for like jibs and things like that. I'd recommend it to like intermediate park riders or beginner too, because it's pretty versatile for butters and for ollies and things like that. Yeah, I haven't ridden it a ton out here in New Zealand yet, but I'm sure I'll get more days as the season kind of kicks in. And then finally, I've been riding the Clue snowboard bindings. And there's a funny story with these Clues. I actually didn't bring them out to New Zealand because the pair they sent me to Vancouver actually got stolen. So if anybody's out there watching and you've got my Clue bindings, I mean, I guess you got them, so way to go. But they managed to send me out a pair to New Zealand. And yeah, I've been super stoked on these bindings. If you guys don't know about Clues, if you can see the high back here, they have the release. So they do up just like traditional straps. So you get your boot in there and you strap it up nice and tight. And then you can use the step in and out function. This comes with your boot. And the interesting thing is I actually have two sets of bases. So if I pull this guy out as well, now I can move the bindings. If I thought it was gonna be a park day and it turns out that it's going to be kind of like a pow day and I've got my board, I can just click this into the other board. So pretty cool design, made in Germany. So far I've been loving the Clues. Yeah, watch out for more videos testing these guys out and riding them around the mountain. So I just wanted to highlight all that gear for you guys, some really fun stuff. If I was gonna pick one thing out of the bunch just at the moment, these Arthur Longo pants. Don't sleep on these pants. I know that these are the 2023 versions, but the 2024 are looking really stylish and they're just so comfortable, lightweight. Definitely get the Gore-Tex version though. If you can swing the Arthur Longo Gore-Tex Vulcan pants, these are the ones. Yeah, thanks for watching guys. I'll put links to all this gear in the description. Hope you're having fun with this snowboarding. I'll catch you in the next video.